people will be quite disappointed by the Scharnhausen volcano. There's not much to see, and there never was a volcano here. Nevertheless, this small depression is of outstanding importance for the geology and the geomorphology of southwest Germany, especially the Swabian Alps. The Swabian Alp is the most striking cuesta that divides southern Germany. Its limestone layers were formed during the Jurassic Age in the shelf seas of the Tethys Ocean. This is the ocean that split the supercontinent Pangaea in an east-westerly direction, even before the Atlantic Ocean was developed. The limestone layers that today form the escarpment, in German called Alptrauf, and the Swabian Alp Plateau were deposited during the Upper Jurassic, which in Germany is also called the White Jurassic or Malm. Underneath are the clay and marl layers of the Black and Brown Jurassic. They are mainly found in the northern pediment of the Swabian Alp. During the subsequent Cretaceous period, the area of the present Swabian Alp rose and the sea retreated. However, the largely preserved White Jurassic strata and relics of tropical tower karst on the Franconian Alp, for example near Tüchersfeld, show that in the Cretaceous period not only erosion prevailed. A further massive uplift of the Jurassic strata did occur with the beginning of the Cenozoic. In the course of the Alpine folding, the Jurassic layers in the Swabian Alp region were uplifted and tilted to the south. This formed the prominent steep escarpment at the Swabian Alp's northern edge. Furthermore, a continuous erosion and backshifting of the cuesta set in. The Witnesses Mountains, rising from the northern pediment of the Swabian Alp, and the Urach-Kirchheim volcanic field, also known as the Swabian volcano, play an important role in the research about the cuesta development. The so-called Scharnhausen volcano is of outstanding importance. It is the northernmost outlier of this volcanic area. The village of Scharnhausen nowadays is a district of Ostfildern and is located in the immediate vicinity of the Stuttgart airport. Traveling from Ruyk to Scharnhausen, one passes over the Filder Plateau and comes to the steep depression of the Kirsch Valley. In this valley, the Castle Scharnhausen is situated, and about 500 meters away from it, one can find the relics of the volcanic pipe, which is called Scharnhausen Volcano. The Scharnhausen volcano erupted about 17 million years ago. The dating is difficult because the results of potassium-argon dating and datings relying on fossil findings in the case of the Swabian volcano differ quite a lot. But most researchers agree that the active phase of the Swabian volcano spanned the time from 19 to 12 million years ago, during the geological epoch of the Miocene. Since no lava flows occurred, the Scharnhausen volcano like the entire Swabian volcano must correctly be called a volcanic pipe or diatreme. Its formation might be visualized as follows. Magma rises in connection with mantle plumes, following tectonic fractures and zones of weakness, but gets stuck far beneath the surface. The associated hot gases heat up the groundwater and cause explosive deflagrations. Crater-like depressions are formed, similar to the Mars on the Eiffel. The chimney at the Neufener Steige proves that the temperatures in the vents of the Swabian volcano were probably not very high. They were not sufficient to deform or change the neighboring limestone rocks. Therefore, a clear boundary between the dark breccia of the volcanic vent and the white Jurassic limestones is visible. Since the explosions occurred more than 10 million years ago, nothing is left of those volcanic structures that once covered the landscape. Only the vent fillings of volcanic rock, in most cases tuff breccias, can still be traced embedded in the white Jurassic strata. There is an outcrop of the tuff pipe of the Scharnhausen volcano in the Kirsch Valley. The diatreme has a diameter of about 50 meters. About 350 such diatremes have been located in the Urach-Kirchheim volcanic field. Quite often, and also easy to recognize, the tuff chimneys of the former diatremes form the stabilizing cores of Witenesses Mountains. These are located in front of the northern escarpment, in German called Alptrauf of the Questa. They include the Jusi, also the Metzing-Weinyard Mountain, the neighboring Hofbühl, and the Limburg near Weilheim an der Teck. The Witenesses Mountains owe their name to the conception that they, as isolated peaks in front of the Alptrauf, which are composed of the same rock layers as the Swabian Jura, bear witness to the fact that the Questa of the Swabian Alp once extended much further to the north. Geographical textbooks quite often define only those isolated mountains near the Alptrauf as Witenesses Mountains, which were not preserved because of their stabilizing basalt chimney filling, but because of tectonic and hydrological peculiarities, such as the three Emperor Mountains, the Teck Mountain, or the Ipf. I do not think this distinction makes much sense. It is based, albeit somewhat hidden, on the assumption that the Witenesses Mountains with volcanic fillings are volcanic mountains. Some of them, like the Limburg, fake a stratovolcano by their homogeneous cone shape. But in this case, the outside appearance of these mountains has no direct connection to the Swabian volcano. Apart from the pipe material, these mountains are built up by the same rock strata as the Swabian Jura, and no ash or magma layers have been deposited. The northern escarpment of the Swabian Jura is exposed to particularly intensive chemical and physical weathering. Even today, large landslides occur again and again. The best known is the Mössinger landslide, which occurred in 1983. But also the Hausener Cliff in the upper Fils Valley can be traced back to a cataclysmic landslide which occurred at the end of the last ice age. In In this manner, the Alp trough is constantly relocated to the south. And a basic question of geological and geomorphological research is, how far north did the Alp plateau extend at the beginning of the Neogene? An important clue to this is provided by the Vitenesses Mountains. Some of them still contain white Jurassic layers. For example, the Rechberg near Schwäbisch Gmünd. In other places, such as the Hohenstaufen, these layers no longer exist, but eroded debris from the Alp trough, meaning white Jurassic rocks, survived in some locations. An example for this is the so-called Spielburg, directly below the summit of the Hohenstaufen mountain. It probably originated in the following way. Millions of years ago, when the Alp trough was still as far north as today's Vitenesses mountain of the Hohenstaufen, a massive landslide occurred, and the blocks of White Jurassic have withstood the erosion in this depression until today. These lowered White Jurassic boulders also occur frequently in the vicinity of the former Mare lakes produced by the Swabian volcano. During the steam explosions, the boulders were first ejected and then fell into the resulting chimneys. On this lower level, they were protected against the later erosion of the White Jurassic strata. Today, they lie as displaced rocks, often exposed by erosion, on the former vents. For example, on the Hohen Bohl, a foothill of the Teck Mountain, or on the slopes of the Randecker Mar. The Randecker Mar, one of the largest diatremes, is situated today directly on the Alp trough, very close to the Schopflocher Borg. The regressive erosion of the Alp trough has consumed about a quarter of the Randecker Mar. It therefore opens up like an amphitheater to the Limburg and the foothills. On the Swabian Alp plateau, the tuff vents can sometimes be recognized because small lakes or bogs have formed on their top. These are very atypical for a karst region. Among the best known are the Schopflocher Borg, the Randecker Mar and the Zeininger Hüle. The Scharnhausen volcano, respectively the Scharnhausen diatreme, is of particular importance as an indicator for the regression of the Alp trough. Although most of the 350 diatremes located by Moisenest are concentrated in the region between Weilheim, Metzingen and Urach, there are a few exceptions. The Scharnhausen volcano is the northernmost diatreme. If one stands on the Filder Plateau, above the Kirsch Valley, where this diatreme is located, the northern escarpment of the Swabian Jura lies a good 25 kilometers further to the south. For more than 100 years, the Scharnhausen diatreme was considered scientific proof that the Alp trough had been eroded back by about 25 kilometers in the last 17 million years. In 1892, the geologist Wilhelm Branco claimed to have found rock debris from the lower White Jurassic in the outcrop of the Scharnhausen volcano. This seemed proof for the hypothesis that at the time of formation of the diatreme, the plateau of White Jurassic strata had still reached into this area. Generations of geography and geology students learned this, and it is pronounced on the website of Scharnhausen and the display boards in the Kirsch Valley. In 2018, the geologist Günther Schweigert became aware of discrepancies in the records and made a new evaluation. He examined rock material in the Scharnhausen outcrop and had a look at the rock collection created by Branco, most of which had been preserved in its original composition in the Geological Institute of the University of Tübingen. The result was distinct and surprising. The pieces that Branco had attributed to the White Jurassic, due to the material composition and fossil content, were rocks from the Black Jurassic. And thus, the hypothesis that the plateau of the Swabian Alb had reached into the area of today's Scharnhausen 17 million years ago was no longer valid. This is further proof that classical geomorphology has often relied on assumptions and rough estimates, and that many of its scientific hypotheses still need to be much better substantiated, especially with the involvement of neighboring sciences.